Replacing a front end on a 1913 Model T.
1912
Model T. We got the new one. New one, right? Or new one.
Rebuilt.
Yeah. Rebuilt. So we're going to swap the spring. We need two more of these leaf springs. You have to cut the bolt off. It was seized in there. It's seen a lot of rust. It goes underneath that channel. So we have to cut the... And now we're going to replace that. What is that bar called that goes to the center?
Wishbone.
The wishbone. That's what centers the axle. It braces it. Yep. The horn is almost as big as
the engine.
Maybe I want to put heat on this. Maybe not. Between the two, so that don't break this one. Well, we got one off. Yeah, I just ground a flat so we don't have a shoulder. Why don't we try that
first.
Right. When we wanted it to,
yeah.
It didn't. Boy. Can always dip this whole thing in vinegar overnight, get all the rust off. So this could be clean enough right here. Guess that's it for that battery. Yep.
Hold that. Let's keep that in there.
Okay.
Now this one's in better shape. This one or this one? About the same height.
About the same. Yeah, there's probably deeper pitting on this one here. All right. This one just where the spring is.
You get a clamp?
No.
No?
Well, yeah, because it's going to need to compress.
Yeah. Excuse me.
Yep. Just give me a couple clamps for one.
Grab that drill, steal the battery from it. No, that's okay, it'll go a long ways.
Actually,
I got it all up.
Yeah, I just gotta compress it. Give me the clamp. You know what? I think I could compress them and put the nut on without the clamp.
Yeah.
Yeah. You want to spray these before we put them on?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Oh, yes. And that paint dries in that cold galvanized ink. It dries within like... put it on the trailer. Yeah, out in the sun, it'll dry super fast.
Well, we know how to put it back in order.
Yep. Well. Let me get that. Let's see what type that is, and I'll get a ring for it.
With a classic bacon macchiato featuring our signature sauce. Like a small dustpan or something.
Yeah.
Get this rust.
Half inch.
Dinosaurs, come on! Experience the ultimate track adventure racing adventure. See the
trouble. Any trouble you look there? No?
I just used it this morning.
What size are them?
Huh?
Underneath, what size are them?
Nope. If you don't have it, it's 916.
Up there is a ratchet. 9/16.
Half.
Half.
You got a.
Yeah, I got. Here's a 9/16. I got the pocket cut right here. Big battery pack up there dead or?
I switched it out.
Oh, that big one right there.
I don't know.
Oh, holy Christ. This big monitor here is ready to rock and roll.
Yeah.
This big ass. Battery pack, that's the biggest one I got. It's fully charged.
Okay. What are we doing with this?
Well, we can take it and move it out of the.
Can you pick up your end?
Yeah. I can pull, I just can't hold. I mean, move it for shit yet.
Hold up. Okay.
The big seat lamp is.
So let's see, what direction does that go? Facing up or down?
Up.
Like that? That?
Yep. If you want to turn it like.
So this bolts to.
Right here.
Down here. Yeah. Okay. How about a little bit of this?
Okay.
I might be on the gun already. Eric.
Probably.
Check it.
Nope.
Nope. Bigger?
More bigger.
More bigger. I don't have it up there. Haven't got that one yet. Probably 1 inch. That's 7.
Yeah.
7/8.
Yep.
I turn on the lights. You're up here on the camera.
No bushings. Just goes like that, huh? No bushings on it.
No.
Wow. Quite a bit of slop in that. On the wishbone. Yeah. Oh, Jack, too big. This is 1/8, 1 1/8. You sure it's not metric?
No.
Positive? Yeah, yeah. Yep. You don't have a ratchet, just grab a... Yeah.
That's bigger.
I mean, never mind. We do have the air.
Yeah, see this right here?
It's taper?
Yeah. This piece and this piece right here. Look. Seems like that.
Oh, I see.
Like a tire?
Yeah, yeah. I see. Almost like a lug nut.
Yeah.
That's just like a lug nut.
Lug nut grip. Oh, that switch was hard as hell.
Yeah, I'd say.
Airtight.
You want to put the cotter pin in?
Yeah, line it up and...
I don't know how far to go. Yeah, she's snug.
Oh, yeah. You just got all these pins and bushings.
Yeah, I see that.
And this is all, the pin is new. Just put the card pins on this one.
Oh.
This. See, I got the oiler.
So basically, this is the only thing that keeps this front end.
Yeah. And.
From walking.
Yes, that's it.
Wow. No wonder my T wobbled when we did 80. It wasn't designed for that, huh?
No.
Well, basically, this is your Panhard bar. Or is that your steering rod?
Steering rod.
We'll put the spring pack now because it's easier.
Yeah. You gotta flip those over and paint them.
Yeah. In. is. While that's dry, bottom half of that.
Still stuck on the other end. Still stuck on that other one.
Yep. Oh, is there a, there's a liner on it.
Yeah.
There's a rubber liner.
Yep.
You have a new one?
Think so.
You need one. This one's all tore up.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Let's see if I got one.
Yeah. Since we've gone this far,
yep, with this rack and painting, where's the model putting it?
Yeah, that was torn. So that's what sandwiches the two together.
Yeah, it's this. And then you got this little,
Keeping the new country coming,
96.3 Cub Country. Let me see if I got this. Just these two halves like this, and then there's this little steel piece that.
Yeah.
An extra stand so we can
what?
Kind of support that up a
yeah,
little bit.
Yeah. Right underneath the bench, so I've been stacking them under there.
Right, you know, there. We do that, the back's going to fall off.
Oh.
You know what I mean? That's
fine. You can put all that together and put just two bolts, because that'll drop down. I can put, if I find the
squeeze it.
Because I can put that on later.